Let's create animations in ArcGIS Pro. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit subscribe below if you haven't already. Okay, so what I'll show you today is how to create animations in ArcGIS Pro. Animations allow you to tell a story with your 2D and 3D GIS content, such as showcasing a critical region or flying through a 3D view of the area and turning on analysis results. You can then export your animation to a common video format. In our example, we will be animating a walk along a path in 3D. First, we open a new scene and zoom to our area of interest. Following this, we will import our shapefile into Pro. If you guys are new to Pro, you can check out my playlist here. And just to note, my shapefile doesn't actually have 3D information, so it actually wraps itself over the elevation established in ArcGIS Pro. After adding my files, I pan and zoom to the area I will begin recording along my path. Animations are built by defining a small set of keyframes or waypoints within the view and configuring how the software interpolates the transitions between them. A keyframe contains the viewpoint, layer visibility, time, and range property of the map, which can be used singularly or in combination depending on your needs. To begin recording your flight or path, you must enable the animation tab in ArcGIS Pro. To get to this tab, you go to the View tab here, and under the animation subsection, you can click Add. This enables the animation tab. To start recording along your path, you simply select Create First Keyframe to record the first frame in your animation. Now that you have your first frame, you must pan and zoom along your path and record a frame by selecting the Add Frame button at either every change in direction or perhaps every few meters if it's along a straight line. That choice is up to you, but you must at least pan along your path until you achieve your desired outcome. In my case, I did a previous version of this path with fewer frames, and the outcome wasn't to my desire, so I went back and re-recording my path by adding a few more keyframes. Now that we have all our frames, then we will export this to a video. But first, I want to append my transition time between the frames in an effort to speed up the video as well as reduce its time. Following this, I export a draft video since this requires limited space, and I just want to quickly see how my video looks before doing my final export. You can always export this to a higher quality once you are satisfied with your outcome. As usual, thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorials or if you have other tutorials that you'd like to see. Thanks again, and see you next time.